Hello, hi, Assalamualaikum, and very good morning, girls. Okay, let's start your day today with a positive attitude. Okay, let's cheer up and always smile, right? Okay, so for today, we are going to continue chapter 15. Yeah, chapter 15 with the 15.3 menstrual cycle. Okay, menstrual cycle. Okay, let's go to the learning standard that you have to cover for today. Okay, 15.3 menstrual cycle. So pupils are able to analyze the changes in the levels of the hormones involved during menstruation, follicle development, thickening of the endometrium, ovulation, and corpus luteum formation. Okay, so you have to explain the changes, changes in the level of hormones, level of the hormones involved during all this process in the menstrual cycle. Okay, so let's go to the next slide. Okay, before we go more to the hormones, the role of the hormones in the menstrual cycles, okay, let's take a look. What is the menstrual cycle? Yeah, so what is a menstrual cycle? It is a cycle that involves the production of a secondary oocyte and thickening of the endometrial wall throughout one cycle. Okay, it involves the production of the secondary oocyte. Yeah, secondary oocyte refer to the female gametes, right? Okay, and this secondary oocyte is referred to the immature female gamete. So once immature, it will develop into or produce into ovum. Okay, and in thickening of the endometrial wall, thickening of the endometrial wall, through one cycle. So in this cycle, the endometrium becomes soft, thick, and rich with the blood vessels. Alright, okay, for what? To prepare the endometrium for embryo implantation. For embryo implantation. Okay, so if fertilization does not take place, the secondary oocyte will die and the endometrial wall will shed, lead to the bleeding known as menstruation. Okay, so that is referred to the menstrual cycle. Okay, let's take a look on this cycle. So this is referred to the menstrual cycle. Yeah, it involves the production of the secondary oocyte and the thickening of the endometrial wall. Okay, so in the cycle, endometrium becomes soft, becomes thick and rich with the blood vessels to prepare for the embryo implantation. So if the fertilization does not take place, the secondary oocyte will die. Yeah, and the endometrium wall will shed off and lead to the bleeding. So this bleeding known as menstruation. Okay. Alright, so this is referred to the phases of the menstrual cycle. So this is referred to the menstruation phases. Okay, so this is repairing phases. The endometrial wall are repaired here. And then this is referred to the fertile phase. Fertile phase. Okay, refer to the in day 14, ovulation will occur. Ovulation will occur usually on day 14, and the Graafian follicle will release the secondary oocyte. So if fertilization take place, the secondary oocyte will be fertilized by the sperm, and form the ovum and the fusion of the nucleus of the sperm and ovum will form the diploid zygote. Okay, and the uterine lining will continues to thicken here. Continues to thicken and will support the embryo, yeah, for the embryo implantation. So if there is no fertilization, what happened to the endometrium wall? So it will start a new cycle again. Yeah, it will start the new menstrual cycle again. Where are the bleeding occurs here? Okay, and they will start the new cycle. Okay, same phases also occur. Alright, okay. So it will continue to occur if the fertilization does not take place. Alright, now, so let's take a look on the hormones, yeah, that involve in the menstrual cycle. So, okay, so there are four hormones, yeah. There are four types of the hormones that involve in the menstrual cycle. So this hormone you have to memorize its function, yeah. Alright, okay, so we go first to the first hormone involved here, which is follicle stimulating hormone. A follicle stimulating hormone that released or secreted by pituitary gland. Yeah, pituitary gland is our master of gland. Yeah, do you remember that? Okay, so FSH. Okay, what is the function of the FSH? Okay, it will stimulate the follicle growth. Yeah, follicle growth in the ovary, yeah. Okay, follicle growth refer to the primary follicles, secondary follicles, and the Graafian follicles. All right. Okay, so these follicles are stimulated by the FSH. Okay, then second function of the FSH stimulate the release of estrogen. Yeah, release of estrogen. Okay, next we go to the second hormone, yeah, that you have to know, which is luteinizing hormones. Yeah, luteinizing hormones that stimulates. Okay, stimulates what? Ovulation. Okay, again, what is the ovulation? Ovulation refers to the releasing of the secondary oocyte into the fallopian tube. Yeah, by what? By Graafian follicles, right? Okay, so the luteinizing hormone will stimulate the ovulation, causes the formation of the corpus luteum. Okay, corpus luteum will form after ovulation. Yeah, so after ovulation, the Graafian follicle will turn into the corpus luteum, and also stimulate the release of progesterone. So please at least you memorize one function of the luteinizing hormone, yeah, which is stimulate ovulation. Okay, next we go to the third hormone. Yeah, third hormone. Okay, so this hormone is secreted by the ovary. Yeah, ovary. Okay, ovary itself will secrete the hormones. Okay, what are they? Estrogen and progesterone. Okay, we go first to the estrogen. Okay, what is the function of the estrogen? Repairs and stimulates the thickening of the endometrium. Yeah, repairs and stimulates the thickening of the endometrium wall after menstruation. Yeah, after menstruation. So the estrogen will repair. Yeah, will repair and will stimulate the thickening the endometrium wall again after menstruation. And the other function stimulate follicle growth, right? And stimulate the FSH and LH release prior to ovulation, yeah, or before to ovulation. Okay, so that is the function of the estrogen. At least you can remember one of the function of the estrogen, which is repair, yeah, and repair the endometrium wall or stimulate the thickening of the endometrium wall. Okay, now we go to the progesterone. Yeah, progesterone. Progesterone also secreted by the ovary. Yeah, okay. What is the function? Stimulates the thickening of the endometrium. Okay, stimulates the thickening of the endometrium. Okay, that is the function of the progesterone. Okay, making it thick, folded and rich in blood vessels to prepare for the implantation of embryo. Okay, the other function is stop the release of FSH and LH to prevent follicle growth and ovulation. Okay, so right, okay, so all of these are referred to the function of the four hormones that involve in the menstrual cycle. Okay, what are the hormones? They are FSH, LH, estrogen, and progesterone. Alright? Okay, now we are going to discuss what happened during menstrual cycle. Okay, so we divide into four phases here. Yeah. Okay, first we go to the day 0 until day 5. Okay, day 0 until day 5 in the menstrual cycle. Yeah, so menstrual cycle will begin when the menstruation occur on the first day. Yeah, when the bleeding occur on the first day, that is the first day of the menstrual cycle. Yeah, okay. Right, so this is referred to the graph of the hormone level in the menstrual cycle. Okay, usually menstrual cycle is 28 days. Yeah, so after 28 days, it will start the new cycle. Yeah, usually for the normal people, so the menstrual cycle day is around 28 days. So this is referred to the follicle development during the menstrual cycle. Yeah, from day 0 until day 28. Yeah, so this is referred also to the changes in the endometrial thickening from the day 0 until day 28, yeah, of the menstrual cycle. Okay, so we are going to discuss what happened during day 0 until day 5 first. Yeah, okay, day 0 until day 5. Okay, so it start from here. So this is day 0 until day 5. So this is around here. What happened during during phases? Yeah, okay, so this is also same. Day 0 until day 5. Okay. Let's go to the explanation here. Okay, before a menstrual cycle begins, okay, before a menstrual cycle begins, the level of hormone is low. Yeah, the level of the hormones is low. Okay, before it start menstruation occur or menstrual cycle occur start. Yeah, the level of the hormones is low. So cause the thickened endometrium will shed. And menstruation will begin on the first day. Okay, so here on the first day, menstruation will occur. Okay, we can see here, yeah, on the endometrial thickening, so the endometrial wall are shed off here. Okay, and menstruation will occur. So this is referred to the menstruation, the shed off of the endometrial wall. Okay. A menstrual cycle begins when the hypothalamus releases the gonadotropin releasing hormone. Okay, yeah? So GNRH, okay, gonadotropin releasing hormone. So what is the function of the GNRH? It will stimulate the pituitary gland to release FSH. Yeah, to release the follicle stimulating hormone. Okay, so and also stimulate the releasing of the luteinizing hormone into the blood. Okay, these two hormones is very important in the menstrual cycle. Okay, and the FSH stimulate follicle growth. Okay, so back to the function of the FSH just now, it will stimulate the follicle growth. Yeah, stimulate the follicle growth in the ovary. Okay, so this is referred to the development of the primary follicle. Yeah, from day 0 until day 5, yeah, it is stimulated by the FSH, yeah, follicle stimulating hormone. So within the primary follicle, the oocyte, okay, the primary oocyte grow into the secondary oocyte, which is contained within the graafian follicle. Okay, so means here the primary follicle will develop into the graafian follicle, yeah, that is stimulated by the F FSH. Okay, the growing follicle release estrogen, which encourage follicle maturation and also encourage endometrial wall repair. Yeah, so this growing follicle will release estrogen at the same time, yeah, to encourage the follicle maturation and also encourage the repairing of the endometrium wall. Okay, next, the low level of the estrogen inhibit the release of the FSH and LH via a negative feedback mechanism, which is in turn prevents the growth of the new follicles. Okay, so at this time, the estrogen level is still low. Yeah, it's still low. So when the low level of the estrogen low, it will inhibit the releasing of the FSH and LH. Okay, and it will prevent the growth of the other follicles. So means that only one follicles will grow at this time. Yeah, only one follicle will grow at this time. Okay, so what you have to know on the day 0 until day 5, okay, you have to know that the FSH and FSH and luteinizing hormone are released into the blood at this time. Yeah, at this time. So what is the function of the FSH? FSH will stimulate the growth of the follicles in the ovary. Yeah, the growth of the follicles in the ovary. And at the same time, the follicles will secrete estrogen. They will secrete the estrogen but low level only, that encourage the endometrium wall repair. Yeah, okay, we can see here, okay, after shedding here, the endometrium wall is start to thicken again. Yeah, okay, that's stimulated by the estrogen. Alright, okay, that is what happened on the day 0 until day 5. Yeah, as day 0 until day 5. Okay, so you have to know what? You have to know that. Okay, FSH and LH are released into the blood. Okay, what is the function of the FSH? It will stimulate the follicle growth at this time, yeah, in the ovary. Yeah, okay, and then the estrogen will encourage the repairing of the endometrium wall. Okay, that's all. Right, okay, now we go to the day 6 until day 14. Okay, starting from here, day 6 until day 14 here. Okay, so day 6 until day 14 here. Yeah, day 6 until day 14, same also. Day 6 until day 14 here on the follicle development. And here on the changes in the endometrial wall, day 6 here until day 14 here. Okay, so we are going to discuss what happened in the menstrual cycle at this time. Yeah, so estrogen level rises. Okay, estrogen level, we can see here at day 6, okay, it starts to rise, okay, estrogen starts to rise and peaks on day 12, okay, peaks on day 12, yeah, and stimulate the hypothalamus to secrete GnRH, okay, so the high level of the GnRH stimulate the pituitary gland to release more FSH and LH. Okay, so when there is a rise of the estrogen, it will stimulate the GN, the secretion of the GnRH, and GnRH will will stimulate the secretion of the FSH and LH. Okay, means here, okay, the level of the FSH, yeah, FSH a little bit more higher here, and also the LH also increasing here. Okay, LH increase, okay, and FSH also increase. Alright, okay, so the LH level rises until it peaks on day 13. Okay, let's go to the LH here. Okay, LH level here rises, okay, it peaks on day 13. Okay, peaks on day 13 here, leading to ovulation. Yeah, leading to the ovulation and release a secondary oocyte. Release a secondary oocyte from the graafian follicle on day 14 here. Yeah, okay, on day 14. So ovulation will occur because of the height level of the LH. Okay, do you still remember what is the function of the LH? LH will stimulate ovulation. Okay, because of the height level of the LH, it will stimulate the ovulation to occur on the day 14. Okay, means that the secondary oocyte are released okay, into the fallopian tube yeah, from the graafian follicle. Okay, LH also stimulate the follicular tissue left behind to transform into the corpus luteum. Okay, so LH also stimulate the graafian follicle turn into the corpus luteum. Okay, that is what occur on the day 6 and day 14. Okay, I repeat what have occurred here. Yeah, the estrogen level increase. Okay, increase. Okay, the estrogen level will increase, and it will stimulate the secretion of the more FSH and LH. Yeah, more FSH and LH. Okay, and then when the level of the LH okay arises, yeah, it will stimulate the ovulation occur, yeah, stimulate the ovulation occur at day 14, okay, and will cause the ovulation, yeah, okay, cause the ovulation, all right, okay, that is what occur on the day 6 and until day 14. Okay, so at this time on the endometrial wall, okay, we can see the endometrial wall is still repairing and it will start to thicken again. Yeah, start to thicken again here, okay, because the estrogen level increase. Okay, here, okay, follicle development, we can see here. Yeah, okay, follicle, the secondary follicle develop into graafian follicle, and then the graafian follicle will release the secondary oocyte. Okay, that is called as ovulation. Alright, okay, so that is what occur on the day 6 until day 14. Okay, now we go to the day 15 until day 21. Day 15 until day 21. Okay, after ovulation occur, start from here, day 14 until day 21. Okay, so at this phase. Alright, okay, so at this phase, right? Okay, so starting from day 15 until day 21 here. Okay, so what can we see from the graph here, from the hormone level? We can see here, okay, the progesterone increase. The LH level decrease. The estrogen level also increase. Okay, all right, okay. Next, we go to the explanation. LH stimulate the corpus luteum to secrete estrogen and progesterone. Okay, so the LH here peaks on the day 14 also stimulate the corpus luteum. Yeah, okay, corpus luteum to secrete estrogen and progesterone. Okay, now the progesterone will increase. Yeah, estrogen and progesterone will inhibit the release of FSH and LH. Okay. So because of the estrogen increase, the progesterone increase, it will inhibit the secretion of the FSH and also LH. Okay. Now the progesterone stimulates. Okay. Now we go to the function of the progesterone here, because the progesterone increasing here. So what is the function of the progesterone? It will stimulate the endometrium wall thickening. Yeah, it will stimulate the endometrium wall thickening. We can see here, okay, the thickening of the endometrium wall and enrich with the blood vessel, or we can say that the endometrium wall become vascularized. Yeah, vascularized means that it enrich with the blood vessel. Okay, for what? To prepare for the embryo implantation. Yeah, if the fertilization take place. Yeah, if the fertilization take place. Alright, okay, so that is what happened on the day 15 until day 21. Yeah, so the estrogen level increase. Yeah, the estrogen level increase to stimulate the endometrial wall thickening. All right, now we go to the day 22 until day 28, the last phases. Okay, the last phases here, day 22 here until day 28. Okay, at these phases. Yeah, these phases. All right. Okay, so if fertilization does not take place, if fertilization does not take place, the decreasing of the LH level will cause the corpus luteum to degenerate. Okay, because of the fertilization does not occur, it will cause the corpus luteum degenerate. Degenerate means it will broken down. Broken down by itself. Okay, it will slowly degenerate and it will broken down. Okay, which in turn stop the secretion of estrogen and progesterone. So it will cause the progesterone level decrease, estrogen level also increase because the corpus luteum degenerate. Okay, so without the stimulation from the estrogen and progesterone, the endometrium will shed and menstruation will begin. Okay, so because of the level of the estrogen decrease, progesterone decrease, it will stimulate the shedding of the endometrium wall again. And the menstruation will start. The low level of the progesterone and estrogen will no longer inhibit the hypothalamus and pituitary gland for secreting of the GnRH again, which stimulate the secretion of FSH and LH. So a new menstrual cycle will begin with a new follicle growth. Okay, so after day 28 here, day 28, so it will start the growth of the new follicle and it will start a new menstrual cycle. Okay, so that is what happened if fertilization does not take place. Okay, if fertilization occurs, what happened? If fertilization occurs, the corpus luteum will continue to grow. The corpus luteum will continue to grow. It will stay in the ovary, ovary for a few months, Okay, for what? To secrete progesterone and estrogen. Progesterone and estrogen is very important to stimulate the thickening of the endometrium wall, to support for the growth of the embryo, right? Okay, and this will cause the endometrial wall to continually thicken in order to support fetal growth. Okay, that is what happened during day 22 until day 28. Okay, what you have to know, if fertilization does not occur, progesterone level decrease, estrogen level also decrease, okay, and then it will cause the endometrial wall shed off again, and the menstruation will start again and a new cycle will start, right? Okay. And what happened to the corpus luteum? Corpus luteum will degenerate. Okay. And here refer to the endometrial wall. Okay, endometrial wall. So at day 28, okay, will start after day 28, it will shed off and start a new cycle. Alright, okay, so that is what occurred on the day 22 until day 28. Alright. So I hope you can understand. Right, about the menstrual cycle. Make sure you can involve. You can understand the involving of the hormones level, the changes of the hormones levels, and also relate with the process occur during menstrual cycle. Yeah, all right. Okay, so that's all for now. Okay, please read again and again until you do understand. And please listen to my explanation if you still do not understand. Alright, okay, try to do your own notes. Yeah, try to do the flow map. Okay, or what happened from the day zero until day 28, especially the four phases that I explained just now. Alright, okay, that's all for now, girls. Okay, take care, everyone. Stay safe.